mini superheroes. We're coming up on a mill, old mill. Whoa, here we go. Here's a... parking it up. Yeah.
Those babies when you went by?
No. I saw a little one.
There's at least 12. We know there's at least 12, but there could be as
we're at 82 degrees.
So,
there you go.
But they've been sleeping there for quite a while today. They're
way out there.
The whole herd is pretty respectful of the new babies and the new mommies. Normally by this time they're over here, but they've been parked there for about an hour and a half. Yes, they started out this morning up by the front gate. You may have noticed the piles of crap.
We did, yeah.
They were fresh at 10 o'clock this morning, and the bison were just a little bit further down on that side of the road. Then they went into the trees for about 20 minutes. Nobody could find bison. Then they came out and they did a little jog about to where all the cars are. Then they went down into that corner. There's a little slough area. You might have seen the water standing there. They went in that and they drank and cooled off. And now, then they turned, came right across the road, and they've only made it this far since about noon.
Nap time.
Yeah. Some of those babies were born yesterday or even today.
So. Wow.
And when they're born, they're about 40 pounds. And in October, we will have a managed, every park that's part of this conservation program, we'll have a management day, and everybody gets weighed and microchipped and things like that. And those babies that weigh 40 pounds today will weigh 400 pounds the first week in October.
Whoa, really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So the in-between size you see out there are last year's babies. There's 14 of them. And
wow.
They weighed 600 pounds or 400 pounds last October, so they must be in the 600 pound range now. The bull weighs about 2,000 pounds, and the leader female is about 200 pounds less than him.
Dang.
How many are out here completely?
I think it's in the vicinity of 46.
And all of them are over there, right?
Yep, yep, they're all laying there. Some of them are in that sumac.
Okay.
And it gets wet And then they go in there in the morning. It's like their shower or something. They cool off for the day.
Yeah.
But we have artifacts over here. You can see the size of the bison bones. Any of the dark
colors.
Yes. That's crazy. Yeah.
And I sit there and I think it's really neat that, you know, we all went to school and we learned about all this historical stuff, and then you get to every now and then visit a historical site.
Yeah.
And then
here it actually is.
Yeah. And then when the lead ambassador, when he picked up that rib bone and put it in my hands and then told me it was 3,500 years old, it was like, I'm touching history.
Yeah.
Yes, there's a path that goes the entire perimeter of the park, 5 miles. If you walk the whole thing. Oh, I know. My lady said to me, she said to my daughter, do you know where the terrain? And this lady had a lot of
I don't know if you can see those bison over there. It's a long ways away. Yeah, well, I can barely see him, and I'm here. Yeah.
Have you gone to the waterfall yet?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that was awesome.
Isn't that beautiful? It was dry last year. So all these people would come and they would say, how do I get to the waterfall? And I'm thinking, no, no, 4.5 hours north is Gooseberry.
Yeah.
And so I'm like,
just a couple more miles.
Gave them the straight across the road over here, but it's dry. And then people would say, it's dry. And it's like they came from all over.
Yeah.
So I would say, well, yeah, but you can go all the way down to the bottom, and if it's dry, you can walk in places you could never walk.
Yeah, exactly.
There. So then they were happy. But this year, the waterfall is flowing and gorgeous.
Beautiful.
Have you been over there yet?
No.
Oh, right across. Well,
be straight across.
Yeah, thank you. We got internet over here, so we're streaming now.
Yeah, I know. We're just flinging that camera.
Just flinging it all around. Here's that mill. Let's take a look. Can we go inside?
No. It's locked. Door's on the front.
Door over here, too. Looks like something you can make in Valheim. This building was used to store the customer's grain. So it was brought in and finished product of flour or grist until it could be picked up. It may have also doubled as sleeping quarters for those who preferred to wait until their grain could be milled. I think it's just empty now. Going in. Oh, Let's see. What's down here?